For more inspiring content, subscribe to JKYog and press the bell icon to never miss a latest video.
Maharaji asked me after my studies in Mangal were complete. So Maharaji said, all right, now when you go out, people will think ye to Saraswati ke avatar hai, but I know how many mistakes you make. So he said, look, in this field of preaching, never get discouraged. If you have only 8 people in the audience, just think, oh, they are the Asht Mahasakhis of Radharani, and I am speaking to them. So I said, all right, I fixed up the program in nearby Lucknow. And those, you know, we didn't know how to preach, what to preach. I never had any assistants, so I got about 200 flyers printed. And the program was finalized in one temple. So I went in advance and gave the flyers to the pujari out there. Now the pujari, I don't know whether he used the flyers for toilet paper or whatever. But when the program was to start and I reached there, there were only 7 people. So I said, my God, Maharaji, I said, if there are 8 people and there are only 7 here. Okay, including me, there are 8. So all right, all together. So I said, look, if I open my eyes and speak, then I will lose focus and concentration. So let me close my eyes and speak. So I closed my eyes and started speaking. And finally, when I opened my eyes, there was only 1 person there. I said, where did all the others go? Said, Swamiji, they have all gone home. You are so terribly boring. I said, why did you not go? He said, this sheet on which you are sitting is my sheet. You get up, then I'll go. So I rang up Maharaji. Those days we used to have the landline. And I said, you asked me to preach. I don't think I can ever preach. He said, beta, it is all a consequence of practice. Through slow and steady practice, that proficiency. Similarly, here Maharshi Patanjali is saying, the conquest of the mind will be through slow and steady practice. Keep on putting in your best efforts and the goal will definitely be reached. Next sutra. Drishtanushravika Vishaya Vitrishnasya Vashikara Sangya Vairagyam. Vairagya, a non-attachment, is the practice of detachment from desire for sense objects that are seen or heard. So now he's talking about what is detachment. We have got these 5 senses, and the 5 senses are tugging at the mind. See this, hear this, taste this, touch this, smell this. The 5 senses and the mind. What is vairagya? You deny the senses and you deny the mind. The mind says this is pleasant. You say, no, I will deny it. Why deny it? Why should we deny the mind and the senses? With vivek. With discrimination. So this is the samprajñāt. Using the prajña, your intellect, you say, no. This is making a fool of myself. To run after an illusion, to run after the pleasures of the senses, is like running after a mirage. So with the help of scriptural knowledge, you convince your intellect. If you have read the Prem Ras Siddhant of Maharaji, he explains, look, if there was actually happiness in the world, 3 things would have happened. whatever that object in which you say there is happiness, everybody would get happiness from it. If there is actually happiness in an object, everybody should get happiness from it, number one. Number two, that happiness should always remain today, tomorrow, day after. Number three, everybody should get happiness to the same extent. If these three criteria are fulfilled, that means there is actually happiness. Like if there is a glass of water and you put 5 spoons of sugar. Now, whoever drinks the water will experience 5 spoons of sugar. So if there is 5 units of happiness in a jalebi, if you eat the jalebi today, after 5 minutes, after 10 minutes, you should always get it, and everybody should get 5 units of happiness. Now check it out. Is there any object from which everybody says I get happiness? Take the rasgulla. You get happiness from it? Yes, Swamiji, lots. But there are people, you feed them rasgullas, they say I vomit out. No. There are people who have got lactose intolerance, they say I vomit it out. So if there is happiness in a rasgulla, why is it one person is getting, one person is not getting? Some people from alcohol, they get the highest bliss. And the others, if you force them to take alcohol, they'll vomit it out. Now, if there was happiness there, everybody should have got. Second point, that happiness should always remain. That also doesn't happen. One boy and girl got married, having great expectations of happiness. Saathi jiyenge, saathi marenge. We will live happily ever after. We have found the goal of our life. Everything is all settled and fixed. Now after marriage, the wife came to the in-law's house, the bahu came, and she is received as Mahalakshmi. Her feet are placed on anaj, on grain, on rose petals. And the saas, the mother-in-law, does the aarti. You know, that is how Mahalakshmi is welcomed first day to home. And she also goes and presses the feet of her mother-in-law and her husband, etc. And all the neighbors, they also come. That new bahu has come. Let's go and have darshan. So for the divya darshan of bahu, they also offer dakshina. Everybody is in the seventh heaven. But after that, what happens? This is every house story. 1 month went by and the saas, her eyebrows started twitching. 4 months went by and the husband, his nose also started twitching. 1 year went by and bahu is not well. Somebody told the neighbors, you know, I've heard that Bahu is not doing well. Let's go and see her. I don't have time. First day you were so anxious. Now what happened? I don't have time to go every day. Everybody is becoming detached. 4 years went by and the husband said, Mem saab, aap se kya vivaah kiya? Hamari to life barbaad ho gai. I married you and ruined my life. See, these two on the first day, they were saying, saathi jiyenge, saathi marenge. In other words, if we get happiness anywhere, it doesn't remain. It just keeps on reducing and reducing and reducing and then finishes. Like the chewing gum, you know, when we were little, somebody said, if you grew up in India in the 70s, you must have eaten chiclets. And then what do you do with it afterwards? Then you become, first it's very sweet, then less sweet, then less sweet, then you're detached. So then your classmate is not looking, you put it at his seat, let him sit on it. So if there is happiness anywhere, it should remain. But our own experience says it keeps on reducing, reducing. And the third point is, if there is happiness anywhere, everybody should experience it to the same extent. To the same extent. If there's 5 spoons of sugar in a glass, everybody should get 5 spoons. That also doesn't happen. Let us say there's Ramdat and Vishnudat, you know, two neighbors. Now Ramdat, he passed away. His wife saw, my husband has passed away. She is so shattered, she fainted out there. The son saw, my father is not alive any longer. He started crying, wailing, but he did not faint. Ramdat's friend came. He saw, oh, my Sakha is not alive. He also felt bad. Few tears coming out, some tears in acting. The servant came. Saab nahi rahe. Servant also felt bad, but he did not cry. Theek hai, I'll get another job. Now this news went to the neighbor, Vishnudat. Vishnudat at that time was seeing the TV serial, Kaun Banega Karodpati. And his wife said, have you heard our neighbor Ramdat has become dear to God? Vishnudat did not take his eyes away from the serial. Really, that is very bad news. He had one child. This, well, whatever God wants. He never felt bad at all. That Ramdat had a debtor who had taken 10 lakh rupees from him without anything in return. He came to know that Ramdat is no longer in the world. He said, really? Oh God, you are so merciful and kind on me. See, from one Ramdat, everybody is experiencing different happiness and distress. In the meantime, tragedy stuck, or good news came. That Ramdat had not died. The doctor had made a mistake. He came back alive. His wife, who had fainted, and she had come back to consciousness, she saw, my husband is still here. Oh, she was so happy again, she fainted, this time in happiness. That son who had been crying, he saw, my father's eyes are open and his mouth is open. He had been shedding hot tears. Those hot tears stopped and cold tears started coming out. See, tears of pain are hot in temperature. Tears of joy are cold in temperature. So his cold tears started coming. The friend saw, he was also happy, but less than the son. The servant saw, he was also happy, but less than the friend. And this news again went to the neighbor. So the neighbor's wife said, suna hai, doctor ne galti kar di thi. Our Ramdat is still alive. Vishnudat serial had not yet finished. He said, ye Bhagwan ne bahut badhiya kiya. But he did not feel any excitement there. Now this news went by SMS to the debtor. Debtor said, Bhagawan, tu hasane ke baad phir se rula deta hai. Now all the philosophers of California got together. Let's find out how much of happiness was there in Ramdat. They asked the wife. She said, sola ane, 100%. My experience tells me. They asked the son. He said, no, only 75%. Mother is exaggerating. They asked the friend. He said, they both have given a hyperbole. It's only 50%. They asked the servant. He said, 25%. Saab mein itna hi sukh hai. They asked the neighbor, Vishnudat. He said, neither happiness nor distress. My own experience tells me. There is more happiness in this Kaun Banega Karodpati. Now all the philosophers got together and they said, which of them is telling the truth? Fact is, all are telling the truth, what they experienced, they said. But the happiness was not in that Ramdat. The happiness was in their own thinking. They thought, my full self-interest will be satisfied. So in attaining, they got the maximum happiness. In separation, got the maximum pain. This happiness in distress, we are creating it by our own decision. It is not in the object. We are thinking it is in the object. If we decide there is no happiness in the world, we will not get any distress either. So attachment is created by our own mind. Just like the monkey. You know how is the monkey trapped? Earlier, rhesus monkeys used to be exported from India for research in laboratories in America. And when Morarji Desai became the prime minister, he put a stop to it. So how would they catch the monkey? And a narrow-necked bottle, they would put peanuts and fix the bottle in the ground. So the monkey would come and the hunter is standing behind the tree. The monkey looks around. Anybody here? Nobody here. So he straightens his hand and he puts it in. And then he catches the peanuts. Now having made a fist, when he tries to take it out, it doesn't come out. So the monkey thinks, I'm caught. Chee, chee, chee. All he needs to do is open his hand and it will come out. But the monkey thinks somebody is catching me. He would remain there, the hunter would come and hit him on the head. So similarly, it is our own decision. There is happiness here, there is happiness there that has created the attachment. If we can understand that if there was actually happiness, everybody would have got from that object. That happiness would have always remained. That happiness would be to the same extent to everyone. If it is not the case, means our decision is faulty. So keep this discrimination in the intellect and then remove the mind. 16. Tat param purushakhyater guna Vaitrishnyam. So, now he says there's a higher Vairagya. What is the higher Vairagya? The higher Vairagya is you decide, I am not the body, I am the soul. And because I am the soul, my bliss is not in material things. My bliss is in God. So, from that platform, you situate yourself. For example, if you take a fish out of the water and you say, let me give pleasure to the fish. All right, I will massage the fish in scented oils and I'll put it in a comforter and I'll open its mouth and give it hot coffee to drink. Now the poor fish cannot speak. If it could speak, it would say, I don't want any of this. If you want to give me happiness, throw me back in the water. That is where I'll get happiness. Similarly, we are not matter. We are divine souls. And no matter how much we try, material things will not give us happiness. The source of our happiness will come from the divine God. To have this understanding will lead to a higher Vairagya. So he has now explained both Abhyas, practice, and Vairagya, detachment. Further from this, we will go and see what happens in the two subsequent lectures. Vrindavan Bihari Lal Ki, Srimad Satguru Sarkar Ki,